I have spent a considerable amount of time talking to the neighbors I serve to understand their concerns and how I can make my work work on their behalf and initiate legislation to solve problems and make a positive impact on everyday lives. No meeting touched my heart more than the one I had with John and Colleen Hosbach. Now, I've known John in my previous life as a Radnor Township Commissioner, where he served as our township arborist. I always knew our paths would cross again, but never thought it would be under such sad circumstances. Sudden unexpected death in epilepsy, referred to as SUDEP for short, is when someone with epilepsy who is otherwise healthy dies suddenly, and no other cause can be found when an autopsy is completed. Sadly, John and Colleen Hosbach, who we will hear more from in a moment, know all too well about SUDEP and its devastating impacts.
Morgan took a nap following her nail appointment that afternoon and never woke up. Morgan passed away from SUDEP at the young age of 23. My life will never be the same. The guilt that I feel not being able to help Morgan is unbearable, especially now knowing there were ways to mitigate those risks.
SUDEP is a leading cause of death in people with uncontrolled seizures because the more seizures someone has, the more they're at risk of complications from their epilepsy. This is why educating patients and their loved ones on preventing seizures is so important.
What eats me more than grief is the ignorance that me and even Morgan herself had on her condition. Everyone deserves to know what challenges they will have to face in their lives, and keeping that from anybody is just wrong.
SUDEP is a condition that needs urgent attention because we know very little about it. It occurs most often at night, and the person is often sleeping when it happens, meaning nobody witnesses their death, which leaves many questions unanswered. Right now, the only preventive measure doctors can recommend to someone with epilepsy is to practice seizure management to control their seizures as much as possible. But we want to be able to offer patients and their families more insight than that. And that's the intent behind the bills Representative Williams and I are advocating for today.